Hi, everybody. I'm Melissa. Welcome back to my Toddler Month by Month series. This is month 32 with my toddler, Bracey, and with your toddler. The Bracey update. During his 32nd month, Bracey had some really fun events. He attended his brother Lachlan's high school graduation, and he celebrated his oldest brother Headley's 19th birthday. What's typical for a 32-month-old toddler when it comes to speech and language? Saying well over 100 words. After the age of 2.5, many children witness a big leap in their speech development. Uttering 3 to 4 word phrases, including with an action word like big horsey run. Saying pronouns like I, me, and we. Beginning to understand basic aspects of a story in a book and relating those to their own experience, like saying no, night, night, when a character is going to bed in a book. Inviting you to notice what they're doing by saying look and then saying the word for that thing. Here are some easy language activities to keep in mind with your 32-month-old. Narrate what you do using intonation for words. Is that my suitcase? Is that my suitcase?
No, but it's a suitcase.
Pick up on what your toddler is interested in. Build on their curiosity. If they're interested in trains, talk about trains and go on a fantasy train journey. Encourage your toddler to converse using proper grammar and language. Instead of saying, Bracey, brush teeth, say, Bracey, I would like you to please brush your teeth now. Also, you can literally put words in their mouth. So if they say, brush teeth, speak for them and say, Mommy, may I please brush my teeth? This way, you're modeling for them the language.
No, Bracey has a suitcase.
Bracey has a suitcase? Articulate the names of numbers, colors, furniture, different types of buildings, different types of vehicles, and all other sorts of things that you encounter in your daily life.
What is the plan?
0. Good. Okay, let's count the numbers. Let's count. Ready? Here we go. 7, 6, 5. When your toddler articulates a new word properly, give them a high five and it's cause for a small celebration. When your toddler says something incorrectly, like nay, nay for horse, don't say no, but just say the proper word for that thing, horse. In terms of gross motor skills, most 32-month-old toddlers can walk, run, hop, jump, walk up and down the stairs, kick and throw a ball, climb the jungle gym, go down the slide quickly, and bounce steadily on a seesaw. Don't worry so much about how well your toddler is doing these things. Instead, emphasize getting outside and being active and doing these things as much as you can. Physical activities for a 32-month-old toddler. Keep your toddler moving inside and outside. Take short runs and biking journeys. Here are 5 recommended ball activities for a 32-month-old toddler. I would use a medium-sized beach ball. Have your toddler lie flat on their back. Have them throw up the ball and catch the ball when it's coming back down. Your toddler will end up twisting out of their original position. This activity encourages your toddler to control the trajectory of the ball and to develop the coordination to catch it. Have your toddler lean down, spread out their legs, and toss a ball to you through their legs backwards. Have your toddler throw or toss the ball while aiming and toss the ball from increasing distances. Start from very, very close by and then keep moving backwards and backwards and backwards and see for how long they can try to catch it. Have your toddler throw the ball while balancing on one foot. Potty training 1-on-1. How do I handle potty training? The first step to potty training, like many things with parenting, in my view, is to get organized. Get the materials that you need so that you're ready to go. Here's a basic potty training checklist that's been working for us. Training pants or underwear. I like the ones that are slightly absorbent and they come in really cute sets with fun patterns for boys. A small plastic portable potty. An insert for an adult potty. This is really great for when you're going out and about or visiting grandma. Also find some plastic bags that you can put the potty in and wipes that make it easy to clean. Washcloths, paper towels, additional Ziploc bags. You'll need all these things because you'll be spending a lot of time cleaning up accidents. Take up rugs, cushions, anything that your child might have an accident on, is this will just make it easier for you because they will happen and they're very, very characteristic of the early potty training days. At what age should I potty train my toddler? Experts advise that the ideal age is between 27 and 32 months. However, this can really depend on your child. I found with my girls that they potty trained at about 2.5 and my boys later at around the age of 3. With Bracey, I have a really, really clear deadline because he has to be fully potty trained by his 3rd birthday. Otherwise, he cannot go to his school. He even has to be potty trained for naps. So that is one of my main goals for the summer, is to get him potty trained. How do I know if my toddler is ready to potty train? If your toddler shows interest in potty training, interest in putting on underwear, interest in taking off his diaper, starts to signal at the potty or want to sit down when you're on the potty or go to the potty, I recommend, and this is based on what I've read from experts, seizing the day and going for it. In my experience, when you wait too long, your toddler can lose interest and then it can be even more difficult to start the potty training later on. Bracey's early potty training experience basically went down like this. I had bought these training underwear a few months ago. He saw a package in my room. He went over there. He tried to open the package. I opened it for him, then he tried to put on one of the underwears underneath his diaper, so that day I just took the diapers off. It was a very hard day. We must have had at least 5 accidents, and that's sort of how it went. I would say every day, once or twice, he makes a little pee-pee in the potty. We haven't had any number 2s. We're still using the diaper for naps and at night. Please check back in next month, and I'll report in on how the first month went and how the later potty training stages are going for Bracey. If you're going through this too, hang in there. No matter how difficult it is and what your family has planned, you can't start and then stop. I've heard from moms who have done this. They got ready with the potty training, then they had a big trip planned, they put the diapers back on, and afterwards they had a really difficult time getting their toddler back excited and engaged in the potty training. So once you've gotten on the train, stay on the train, however difficult it is, just get prepared, go with the flow, and stick with the potty training. What do I do when my toddler hits? This is something that toddlers do. They have aggression. They're frustrated. I've noticed with some of my boys especially that when they weren't talking, they tended to hit more. They got frustrated. I've also noticed that when they were low on energy, when it was late at night and they hadn't eaten well, that my kids tended to have more tantrums and they tended to swat more or hit more. I try to take a pretty stern approach when it comes to hitting. I take Bracey away to a new place. I leave the situation. I try to mark the moment. I sit him down and I try to say, we don't hit. For a while I was saying, no hitting, no hitting, no hitting. And because I don't like just always saying the word no, now I'm trying to do something that's called the I message that I learned from a really well-regarded parenting expert named Julie Ross, who believes that when children do something, you have to explain the effect that their actions have on others. So now I say, Bracey, when you hit mommy, you hurt mommy and you make mommy sad and that hurts. So please don't hit mommy. And that seemed to be working a little bit. We had a little one of these episodes last night, actually, because, you know, we eat very late here because I live in Spain, but it was incredibly late. He was very tired. He hadn't eaten and he just sort of started hitting and swatting. He even threw a piece of cutlery. It was not good. So I took him into his room. I did what I told you guys, you know, and shortly after that, I ended up like giving him a glass of milk and getting him to bed. So it's not easy, but what I wouldn't do personally is just sort of say, please don't hit, please don't hit, please don't hit, please don't hit, or even worse with the biting, please don't bite, please don't bite. Because if there's no significant change in what your child is experiencing, I don't think they have any message coming through that they should stop that activity. So let me know how this is going for you, but I believe in marking the moment, making it clear to the child that that activity is not acceptable, and being stern with them, and then trying to explain the effect of their actions on someone else. What do I do when my toddler says bad words? This is kind of a funny one. According to Marielle, Bracey has learned a very bad word in Spanish. Now, we don't know where he learned that word. I had a doctor for my first 5 babies who was actually a very good friend of mine from high school, and her toddler had learned the F word. And they got on a plane, and this little guy was like, and people were staring. He was saying it very loud. They sought out professional advice because they didn't know what to do, and they were told to basically ignore the behavior. So they were like buried in their newspaper and books, like kind of trying to act like that was not their toddler. But there's nothing you can do. Because if you get stern or you discipline, the toddler's getting more attention from it and they can be actually motivated to say more of the bad word. So you have to just ignore it and hope that it goes away. All the more reason to try to have good vocabulary around our kids. What should my 32-month-old be eating? You want to have a wide variety of foods from the basic food groups. Protein, fish, chicken, meat, try to mix in vegetables, pork, all sorts of healthy legumes. Those are very good in terms of protein. Tofu is a great protein source, as are nut butters like peanut butter, almond butter, and cashew butter. Dairy, yogurt, cheese. By this point, your doctor is likely recommending low-fat milk. Dairy should be a big part of your child's diet. Fresh vegetables and fresh fruit. Do not give canned or frozen fruit. Opt for fresh if you can. It's much healthier. It's more nutritious. It has more vitamin C and it provides wonderful hydration to your child. And finally, grains. Opt for whole grains, not white rice, not white flour, not white bread, not white pasta. Try to give the whole grains. They have more fiber. They are more nutritious. They are lower in sugar. That is better for your child. In terms of vitamin D, your child needs 600 IUs of vitamin D a day and 700 milligrams of calcium. So 2 to 3 servings, although a toddler serving is less than an adult serving. It's about 1/4 to 1/2 the size of an adult serving. What is my schedule like for a toddler this age? Your toddler needs about 12.5 to 14 hours sleep over the course of the day. That means 11 to 12 hours at night and a nap of around 1.5 to 3 hours. You might notice your toddler sleeping a little less during the day than they did before. This schedule should be used as a loose framework just to give your day some structure and to keep energy levels consistent, to keep your toddler rested, to keep your toddler well fed. 7 a.m. breastfeed or give breakfast and do a milk feeding. 10 a.m. snack. 12 p.m. feed and lunch. A nap from around 1 to 3, 3 p.m. feed and snack, 6 p.m. dinner, 7:30 p.m. a final milk feeding, and 8 p.m. bedtime. Try to make sure your toddler's awake by 3 p.m. because if they sleep later, it can be hard to get them down at night. What do you do when your toddler refuses to nap? There's not much to do. I would try to keep bringing them back to bed, not making it fun time. If it becomes really impossible, it might become a nice quiet time for them to read or play with some toys in their room. A lot of toddlers will start to nap a bit less at this stage. It's good for you and it's good for them if you can keep this small nap going for a little while longer. Gives you a nice break, gives them a nice break. If they don't nap, I would try to put them to bed even earlier that night. Room darkening shades for your toddler's room. One of the things that has worked the best for me and helped me out the most was to have both blackout shades in the windows on my children's room and liners that were blackout liners on the drapes in my children's room. This really made it easier for me to both get them to bed in the summer, prevent them from waking up super early, you know, in the morning, and have them nap during the day. Some people believe in regular daylight during the day. You can try that too. I never did it. I always blacked out the room. Of course, it was a little trickier when we were away, but it always was something that worked better for me. What is the average height and weight of a 32-month-old toddler? The average weight for a 32-month-old toddler is 30.5 pounds for boys, which is 13.8 kilos, and 29.4 pounds, which is 13.3 kilos for girls. The average height for a 32-month-old boy is 36.5 inches, which is 92.7 centimeters, and for a girl is 36.1 inches, which is 91.7 centimeters. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys back next month for month 33.